Children of class 7, once again we are together with our last part of explanation of the story Professor Shonku and the little boy. Till now we have seen that little boy Khoka was peeping inside Professor Shonku's laboratory, and Professor Shonku has taken his hold of Khoka's hand and took him to the drawing room, and there he found that Avinash Babu, who was a police person, he was sitting there. He was Professor Shonku's neighbor. So he let's see what next is going on in the story. So narrator did not welcome the arrival of Avinash Babu because he was scared that he is going to spread the gossip all over the place that Professor Shonku is having a boy who is of a different mentality and nature, as he is uttering some difficult and some unusual words like there we will see in the later part of the text that how he is uttering the unusual words. I did not welcome his arrival. Avinash Babu loves spreading gossip. If he saw Khoka and realized that little boy was very different from any other, he would go and tell the whole town. Naturally, everybody would wish to meet this extraordinary child, and my house will turn into a fairground, its chief and only attraction being Khoka. So he did not want to give Khoka the highlight, that because he thought that Khoka may feel sick and he can again stick to his bed, because he was a different type of boy, not like five other normal child. Needless to say, Avinash Babu was very surprised to find Khoka on the sofa. "Hey, where did he come from? I don't think I have ever seen in Giridi." "He's come to stay with me for a while," I said. "His father's is my cousin." So he somehow managed that Khoka's father is my cousin. "And what's your name, dear boy?" "Huh? Ectophorbic cerebratonic," he said like that. Then Avinash Babu said that, "What the hell he is telling? Oh my God, Mr. Professor, who is this boy? What is he telling all about?" "That's not his name. Actually, he is giving the scientific description of his name." "Scientific description? Oh my God. Are you now drilling with your new theories on tiny tools like these boys? You're putting your theories on them and you're trying to apply, and you're trying to find out that what is the reaction of the child, or what can be the reaction of five other different children." But Professor Shonku just ignored it. But jokes apart, there was a weird experience that Khoka was kept in the limelight, or put in the limelight, because everybody wanted to have a look to Khoka. But this looking of people to Khoka had a very weird experience. Weird experience means bad experience, dangerous experience. People started to come in lots and bunches and groups and groups and groups to see Khoka and to listen a single different word which will come out from Khoka's mouth, and they are going to enjoy it and they'll fulfill all their queries regarding this boy. Anyways, the things were going on, and Professor Shonku was forced to bring Khoka in the limelight, as they were very stubborn. They told that until we see Khoka, we are not going to leave your house. So he put Khoka in front of them. Everybody, reporters were there, cameramen were there, photographers have also come, and they are also eager, they were very eager rather, to take a snap of Khoka. Even Khoka was getting very irritated because he did not like this type of crowd circling around him. He was a boy of a different mind and mentality. So he always wanted to make himself out of this crowd and stay alone. Anyways, things were going on. In the evening, another gentleman arrived from Calcutta. His name was Shomiran Chowdhury. He said, "What can I do for you?" I asked. I turned out that he was an impresario. That is, he arranged shows for gifts and music dancers. So he said that I'm going to put coca in front of people, and event manager, you can say, in other word. I always give importance to those person who are different than others. So Professor Shongu said that, "So sorry, I cannot accept your proposal. I have to talk with Khoka's parents, because I am not his parent. He is my cousin's son. So his legal guardians are there. I need to talk with them." Then when Khoka was again brought in the limelight, Khoka murmured. Murmured means nijer mone bibi kore kotha bola. He said, "Merest mute." Merest mute means what? "I am tired. I need break. I can't resist anymore." And so when Professor Shonko understood, he said that Khoka needs rest. Please leave him. And he was taken inside the house. Professor Shonko was a bit in pressure that what actually is going to happen in future. Anyways, curious spectators spectators means jara dekhte ishe. They were very curious what happened to Khoka finally, what he did. And the things were going on. Suddenly, turning these thoughts over in head, I must have fallen asleep. Acha. Here is something that over the last few days, I had finished reading 11 books that spoke nothing but possible abnormalities of human brain. Now, Professor Shanku was constantly consulting the books. And Khoka was a very unique and different type of personality. These thoughts were going inside my mind and I felt asleep. Clap of thunder means thanda or jore ekta awaj. I got up. I opened my eyes to see lightning flash frequently and heard a rumbling in the sky. Akash jore dakche and thunderstorms are going on. The room lit up as there was another flash of lightning, and that split second I happened to glance at other bed in my room, Khoka was not there. In the outside, it's raining, flashes are going on. Again, some more flashes are going on. I was just shocked. I turned my face to find Khoka, but I found him nowhere. I jumped on my feet. When something has frozen my blood, where is Khoka? Because he was a different type of child. I mean, what he is going to do, nobody can count. Khoka was sitting on the high tool. Acha, here is some part which you must know. When he was, he jumped on the feet, the narrator, he jumped on the feet and he was searching. And by the time of searching, he found his laboratory's door is open. The lock has been broken. He understood. Something mischievous is going to happen and Khoka is definitely inside. He very, with full of anxiety and shock and fear, he slowly opened the door. And as he opened the door, what did he see? He saw Khoka sitting on a high tool facing work table of the professor. In front of him, in rows, bottles of poisonous lethal acids. Burner is on and something is kept over there. Liquid is being given. Khoka was clutching the bottle contained pterinium phosphate. Pterinium phosphate, can you remember the name? Yes, pterinium phosphate is the acid which has been discovered by Professor Shonku. Right? Professor Shonku was just like a puppet. He was standing over there. Means he was stumbled. I mean, he was speechless. What to do, what not to do? Should I go forward or should I put back? Should I hold and go and hold his hand or should I not move? Should I say, request him to come down from there or should I stay over here? Whatever is going on, let it be. He tilted the bottle, poured just a few drops into the flask. At once, coils of yellow smoke began rising. Khoka realized I was in the room. He turned. He just turned. Khoka was excited. I have done something. Khoka says, where is inhalin? Inhalin is a most potential acid. Potent of all acid. He started to control Khoka. Professor Shonku, please Khoka, don't do it, don't do it. After a huge argument, Khoka did not come back. And finally, he said, where is inhalin, Professor Shonku? And Khoka took 3 drops of inhalin. 1, 2, 3. And then what? Then before I could say or do anything, Khoka picked up the flask and drank the green mixture. Oh my God. Khoka drank the green mixture. Can you see this? Here's the mixture. Khoka drank this mixture. Oh my God. What is exactly going to happen? Khoka was lying down. Professor Shongu very politely and very slowly went towards Khoka. Hold his wrist. Yeah. Breathing is going on. Put his ears on the chest. Heart is also thumping. Just after 5 minutes, Khoka stirred, turned on his face and opened his eyes. The look in his eyes was different. He seemed a little lost and uncertain. But as if he has come out from a dream, he was sleeping for a long, long time. And then the first word that Khoka uttered was a, what should I say, miracle. Khoka said, where is mummy? I want my mummy. Means what? The boy which have till been behaved like an aged person, now he's a boy of 4+. Even he also demand sweets from Dadu. Who is Dadu? Professor Shonku. He's a 60-year-old man. And he was very happy. He hugged, he gave a tight hug to Khoka. And he told that, my dear, I'm going to give you bunches of toffees and chocolates. He took Khoka and dropped this to his house. Now, why did this happen? Why it has not been happened? So many questions are arising in your mind. Even in my mind also, it's polarizing. But what to do, dear? The story ends over here. For knowing so many things, you have to go through the full novel of... This is a part of it, written by Satyajit Ray. So if you want, you can go through the full novel to understand what is the basic matter going behind. Anyways, your text is over. Read it. And it's a huge chapter. So I think if you go through the summary and follow up the videos, I think that will be enough for you to understand. All the required things will be transported to you very soon. Stay healthy, stay fit and fine. Bye-bye.